Hello. People are starting to ask questions and look for advice, and I think I'm going to start sharing more of the answers so that we can help each other while we're still in the process of building up the foundation for our benefit company called Superpower School. And one of the things that came up in the store today was how do you get enough sleep when you've got insomnia? And I thought about that too, and it's a serious problem. So a lot of people I know can't let go or wind down at the end of the day, and they're reaching for prescription drugs to do that. And I'm here to tell you that is a very bad idea. I know people that are dealing with serious health crises after they trusted a health professional who prescribed whatever those things are. I didn't want to say a name out here and promote any of that poison. So anyway, here are a few tips for how to get your sleep back on track, because it doesn't do anybody any good to be a martyr and try and get less than 8 hours of Z's every night. It doesn't work out. Don't do that. You're not sexy for it. You're not better off in any way, shape, or form for cutting back on your sleep. When they've researched deprivation methods, the best way to make somebody crazy or dead is to take away their sleep. So you can do without water and food a lot longer than you can do without sleep. So that all said, here are a few things that I like to do to make sure that I get my full night's sleep. And the first thing you have to do is make sure that you're not stimulating your body to the point where it can't follow its natural biorhythms. We have melatonin that runs the night, and we have cortisol that runs the day. We want those two hormones to be in place in the right order. And a lot of times when we take some kind of prescriptions or eat gross food, you know, junk food, or put other chemical shitstorms in our bodies, their sleep hormones get mixed up. And they've proven that light affects melatonin productivity. So the first rule is start shutting things down. Make it a little dark in your bedroom. Make it cool. Make it quiet. Start in 2 hours before bed. Turn off all your technology. I know it's good for you though. Don't wonder about this. Just try it. And my little friend the other day, Heather Richards, mentioned leaving your phone and all your electronics in the other room so they can charge overnight in another place. And I thought that was a brilliant idea, because all that tech is getting into our system while we're trying to rest, and it doesn't help us sleep. So you want your rooms dark, cool, and quiet. And you really want to try to set your schedule up around the earliest rising time that you have in the week. So if you've got one early morning day that you've got to be up by 6, sadly that's kind of how all your days need to go, because your biorhythms are going to start adjusting to these new habits. And so pick that outlier day and make that your standard. And you can vary your bedtimes up and down by an hour. So let's say you got to get up at 6, then you could get up as late as 7 on the other days and still be within that range. So the goal is you want to give yourself 10 hours of focus on that bed. You're going to have quiet time, taking at least an hour at night, and you want to give yourself the same amount of restful mindfulness in the morning, in that beautiful sweet spot where you're just starting to wake up a little bit, but you don't quite have to run to the bathroom yet. That's when you want to focus and just really concentrate a good 10 minutes on mindfulness, like being really present in this very moment. Like, how does that breath feel on your upper lip right here when you take a breath? How do your toes feel? How does your chest feel when you breathe? Are you breathing from your chest or from your belly? Those little tiny details. Give yourself a good solid 10 minutes where maybe you don't even open your eyes yet right after you wake up. And you're just kind of soaking in what you're going to do that day. You're thinking about how it's going to be and try and, you know, stay neutral with that as much as you can. And then once you've got that dialed and fine-tuned, you'll see a big difference in about a week. So just try that first. The other thing is skip the stimulants after lunch and try not to eat a lot of processed stuff, well, in general, and then that'll be a good start. And I'll check back here and see how you did. Let me know how that works out for you. Sleep is a big deal. That's the tip of the day. Thanks for tuning in. We're at Superpower School. And you can check us out over at YvetteTroina.com in the meantime while we're building that up for happy tips and ways to feel better. Thanks. Bye.